Now that we've talked about quadratics, or squares, we're going to talk about their inverse, their undoing, square roots.
Do you mind telling me what this is all about, mister?
This is read, the square root of 25. And the answer, or the value of this expression is, I think, the number 5. Now, why would the value be 5? Well, as I said, it's the inverse of squaring. So 5 squared is 5 times 5, 5 two times, is 25. So 5 is the number you would square to get 25. So 5 is the square root of 25.
You'll come again.
Let's try another one. This would be read the square root of 16. Now, what do you think the square root of 16 is? 4 is a good guess, because 4 squared, 4 times 4, 4 squared, 4 two times, is 16. So 4 is the square root of 16.
Thank you, sir. May I have another?
Practice makes perfect. This is, of course, the square root of 81. Now think about it. What number squared is 81? Do you know your times tables? You're right. 9 squared is the 9 is the square root of 81, because 9 squared does equal 81. Getting the idea? Not that bad.
Perhaps I could be of some assistance.
In fact, it's going to be of use to you to know the what we'll call the perfect squares and their roots. The square root of 4 is 2. 9's a good square root. I know what the square root of 9 is. Think about it. It's 3. What's the next one? Think about it. We did it. 16. The square root of 16 is 4. The next one? 25. And the square root of 25 is 5. The next perfect square is 36. Square root of 36 is 6. And the square root of 49 is 7. And that is about high enough. Well, we'll go to 64. Square root of 64 is 8. And we just did the square root of 81. So that's high enough. But it will behoove you to get to know those, what I call the perfect squares and their square roots.
Going so soon.
Oh.
Party.
This is algebra. We're going to have to do this with letters also, but it's not that bad. X squared is a perfect square because I can take the square root of x squared. What number squared is x squared? Well, it's x. The square root of x to the fourth, think about it, is x squared. Now, wait a minute.
Now what am I going to do?
This is a perfect square, believe it or not. The square root of x to the sixth. Yep, it's x to the third. Because remember that you add exponents. X to the third times x to the third is x to the sixth. So x to the sixth is a perfect square. As is x to the eighth. Square root of x to the eighth.
Correct, boy wonder.
Is x to the fourth. What's the next one? Are you noticing a pattern? X to the tenth. Square root of x to the 10th is x to the 5th. So any even exponent is going to be a perfect square. All you have to do is divide it by 2, and you'll have the square root. Get the idea?
I'm dangerous. I'm very, very dangerous.
These are going to be the perfect squares of any variable, the even exponents. Okay? Any even exponent is a perfect square. Now, wait a minute.
There's something I have to ask you.
What about the ones that aren't perfect squares, that don't come out exact? Well,
there must be some way. There just gotta be. I've got it.
There is a square root of 14. I want you to know that. I know that it's bigger than the square root of 9. Why did I pick 9? Because the square root of 9 is 3. I know what that is. So, because 14 is bigger than 9. And I know the square root of 14 is smaller than the square root of 16, because 14 is smaller than 16. And the square root of 16, I also know, is 4. So this just doesn't come out exact. It's some number between 3 and 4. And I'll just take a guess that it's about, and it's only about, 3.74. It's not exactly, because if you take 3.74 and multiply it by itself, you get 13.99. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why don't I do 3.75? Well, that'll be too much. So these non-exact square roots are never, we're actually never going to find the exact answer for them. We can just approximate them. Okay, we're going to call them irrational numbers. They're irrational. I can never really write them down. Okay, the non-exact square roots. But you should be able to estimate them. They're hard to deal with. What about the square root of 8? Give me an estimate for the square root of 8. Well, I know it's more than... See why I told you you needed to know the perfect square roots? I know it's greater than the square root of 4 and smaller than the square root of 9. And it's probably closer to 3 than it is to 2, isn't it? So I'm thinking 2.3 is not a good guess because that's not halfway there. So it's probably bigger than 2.5 at least. That's an educated guess. I'm going to say it's about 2.8, and 2.83 is a pretty good guess. Because 2.83 squared equals very close to 8, a little bit too much.
Missed it by that much.
But it's a good guess, and that's all I'd ask you to do is to at least be able to make an educated guess and know what the square root means.
Now I want answers, I shall have answers.
Do you know that you can get square roots with a calculator, especially with these non-exact square roots? The calculator is going to be very useful. Of course, you'll need to know where the on button is. And that's the x squared button, not the square root button. But if you hit second and then x squared, you see, you get the square root, okay? And you're going to need to know where the enter button is also. Because if you hit second, x squared, that'll give you the square root, and then hit some number, and enter, you have to hit enter to tell it that you're done typing the number. It will give you the square root of that number, okay?
No problem.
That will be your answer. Now, if you take that answer and square it to check it, of course, you should get the original question that you had, okay? So that's what the x squared button is for.
I am not programmed to respond in this area.
How about this number? This is not the square root of 8. This is the cube root of 8. Well, think about it. We're going to take a guess as that it's 2. Now let me show you why I think it's 2. It's not the square root of 8. It's the cube root of 8. And so 2 cubed,
Shazam.
2 to the third power, does equal 8. So it's called the cube root as opposed to the square
Excellent.
Root. Get the idea?
Pay attention, son. This is for your own good.
Now, when we don't write a little number up there, we're going to say that it's the square root. Okay, so that is the square root of 64, which we know is 8. Because 8 times 8 squared equals 64. So 8 is the square root of 64. What is the cube root of 64? That's got
to
be a little bit different. Some number cubed. Well, it's not 8, because 8 cubed, 8 times 8 times 8, doesn't equal 64. Give me another guess. 4, and guess what? 4 times 4 times 4, 4 cubed, does equal 64. So 4 is the cube root of 64. 8 is the square root of 64, but 4 is the cube root of 64.
Son, look at me when I'm talking.
Now, when we talk about radicals and roots, if you would, there's going to be some rules. You don't have to memorize them if you'll just check. If you think about it, we'll try some. Any positive square root has two answers. Any number that is positive, if you take the square root, it's going to have two answers. Any cube root is going to have only one answer. And a negative square root is going to have no answers. How can that be?
Are you pondering what I'm pondering?
I'm hoping you know now that the square root of 16 is 4, right?
I know you are, but what am I?
Couldn't it be negative 4? What's negative 4 squared? Isn't that negative 4 times negative 4? Two negatives make a positive, remember. If negative 4 times negative 4 equals 16,
believe it or not,
the square root of 16 can be negative 4. So,
prepare to be astonished.
The square root of 16, that expression, has two answers. Yes, it does. It has positive 4 and negative 4.
Fascinating.
Sometimes, if we get lazy, we write plus and minus 4. Plus or minus 4, that way we don't have to write it twice. So when you see that, you'll know what it means. The two answers.
Hmm.
The square root of 36.
What?
Could be negative 6, if you think about it. Because negative 6 squared...
Sinister forces are at work.
That's not sinister forces. Any positive square root is going to have... two answers. Get used to it. Positive 36, the square root of it, is going to have two answers. Plus 6 and negative 6. Or plus or minus 6. Write that in front of your mom. She'll give you a kiss.
And now for something completely different.
Now the cube root of a number, of a positive number.
No way.
Could that have two answers? Well, let's check it. Negative 2 to the third power... cubed, if you would, is negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. Now, you have an odd number of negatives, so that equals...
something very, very wrong with us.
Oh, negative 8 is not 8, is it? So, the only cube root of 8 is positive 2, not negative 2.
Pay no attention to that man behind the curtain.
So, you're not going to use that answer. A cube root is only going to have one answer, isn't it?
Well, ooh-la-dee-da.
Just positive 2.
Whoa!
Now, we could have a cube root of negative 8, but it's still only going to have one answer. It is going to be, in fact, negative 2. Because negative 2 cubed does equal...
wait a minute.
...negative 8. But positive 2 won't work, okay? So any cube root is going to have an answer. It's just only going to have one answer.
And that's how she wrote.
Only one answer.
Houston, we have a problem.
How about this one? The square root of negative 25.
That, sir, is illogical.
You know why we're going to have a problem here? Well, could it be 5? 5 squared is 5 times 5 is 25, not negative 25. I know what you're thinking.
No!
It's not 5. How about... I know what you're thinking, but let's check it. Negative 5 squared, or negative 5 times negative 5, that equals positive 25.
Nothing for you.
They don't match either.
Ooh, I'm dying.
So it doesn't equal 5, it doesn't equal negative 5. The square root of negative 25... has no real answer. There's no such thing.
Pay attention, son. Look at me when I'm talking.
So in general, hopefully it makes a little more sense, any positive square root or the square root of a positive number is going to have two answers. Any cube root is going to have only one answer. And if you try and take the square root of a negative number, it's going to have no answer. Okay? But you don't have to memorize those. Just check your answers and see if they work.
Not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
Just to get the idea and get it well, let's try working with higher roots.
Pay attention, boys. I'll show you how it's done.
It's really done the same way. They're not any more difficult. The fifth root of 32 is going to be the number that you raise to the fifth power to get 32. the fifth root, what number would I raise to the fifth power to get 32? Consider this. 2 to the fifth, which is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, 5 times. Well, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, times another 2 is 32.
The mother load.
So the fifth root of 32,
you're absolutely correct,
is in fact 2.
I know that, dude.
We know the square root of 81 is the number squared that equals 81. It's 9, isn't it? Actually, it's 9 and negative 9. So the square root of 81 is 9 and negative 9. What about the fourth root of 81? It's not going to be 9. It's going to be the number that you raise to the fourth power to get 81. Anybody have an idea? Well, it's going to be 3, because 3 to the fourth power does equal 81. That's why it's called the fourth root.
Woo-hoo! Genius! That's what it is! Sheer genius!
And actually, there's two answers, isn't there? There's plus 3 and negative 3 to the fourth power, because an even number of negatives gives you a positive answer. Okay, that's enough to give you the idea for the homework.
Dig on before somebody drops the house on you.
Go dig in, will you?